I think it. Yep.
First of all, thank you so much for the amazing speech. And so I want to ask you about the technology part. Mm-hmm. So I know technology and development, it's very good. But recently I read an article about how technology is taking away people's job and it increases unemployment.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to ask you about your opinion.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. I mean, look, there's going to be bumps in the road. One example I read about recently, just to give you perspective over long view of time, I think it was like 100 years ago, 80% of the jobs in America were farm-related jobs. Today, they're less than 1% of the jobs in America. But of course, the yield is probably 1,000% more. But the point is, that was a severe disruption, right? 80% of the population lost their job. The difference, of course, maybe is that it didn't happen within their lifetimes. Maybe it happened like one or two or several generations. The reason it's more pressing nowadays is because of those exponentials. So happening within your life. You know, it's like you grow up, you went to medical school, or you, and then they're like a robot's going to perform the surgery instead of you. You know, it's the disruption is happening within our lifespans. And so I think governments, I think companies need to get together and figure out, okay, so we need, these are systemic disruptions that are fundamentally altering the structure of society within the lifespan of a generation that's not going to go quietly into the night, you know? So what we need is to think about novel solutions that maybe we didn't consider before, such as universal basic income, for example, and other novel approaches. I mean, I just think that the same disruption that we are experiencing needs to encourage us to also disrupt our own thinking about the ways in which we can solve these problems, because we can't just stick to the old ways of operating society when these technologies are disrupting industries the way they are. So of course, I mean, it's a problem. I mean, in America, I think truck driving is still one of the jobs that's the highest number of people do, and self-driving cars have arrived. So that is going to be a problem. I mean, look, there's excitement big picture level, but there is a lot of anxiety as to how we get there in the meantime. People got to pay the bills. And some people are attached to their job for their sense of meaning also. You know, how do people fill their time when they don't have to work? Douglas Rushkoff, the futurist, wrote this article on CNN when he was like, who wants a job? I mean, people want a passion and a purpose. People want a vocation. But who wants a job? I mean, the old industrial model, right? Just be a cog in the machine, in the factory farm. Like, who really wants that? I mean, every human wants to flourish, wants to lend their life to something that they're passionate about. So, you know, we don't want people to be unemployed and not be able to pay the bills, but maybe the idea of the job they didn't like to begin with to be replaced might be kind of cool, as long as we can provide cushions and address people's needs during this transition to this kind of post-job world, perhaps. I also think all kinds of new jobs are going to emerge, but of course, you know, it's hard for this generation. The next one won't care because they'll just be born into that world. So, you know, a lot to think about, for sure.